To tackle diabetic membrane during vitrectomy is a very challenging situation, especially when there is a persistent oozing from the disc despite of raised intraocular pressure, where we cannot use diathermy to tackle this situation. Here we have used fibrin glue as a biological adhesive under air to stop disc bleeding. Fibrin glue is prepared from human fibrinogen dissolved in bovine aprotinin and thrombin in calcium chloride. When the two solutions mix, fibrin monomer precipitated, simulating human coagulation, forming a reticulum which acts as an adhesive and stops the bleeders from the disc. Here in this case, we can see there is a dense vitreous hemorrhage, almost dehemoglobinized blood. We removed the peripheral skirt of the blood and then remove the vitreous. We can see the attachment of vitreous at the disc, and as we removed this attachment and induced PVD, we could see there is oozing from the disc. We raise the intraocular pressure with the hope that while we do laser, the bleeding might stop from the disc, but unfortunately it didn't stop. So we did fluid air exchange and tried to aspirate the blood, but still there was constant oozing. So we switched on to application of fibrin glue. Here we are applying one drop each of two solution, and we can see within few seconds it forms a dense membrane over the disc which stops the oozing. Within 30 to 40 seconds it forms a reticulum over the disc which stops the oozer. Here we can see the membrane formed by the glue stops the bleeding. This is a case of bimanual vitrectomy. We can see there is an advanced PDR with subhyaloid hemorrhage and a very thick posterior hyaloid. Here we are using the cutter to dissect the posterior hyaloid and to get access to the subhyaloid space where we can remove the subhyaloid blood. A very thick posterior hyaloid attached to the posterior pole is dissected carefully, and you can see a very thick membrane which is attached with the disc, which is gently teased with cutter to see whether it can get peeled off easily or not. With few gentle maneuvers, the posterior hyaloid get detached and it is removed with cutter. There is persistent oozing from the disc, which is removed with a suction mode of cutter. Here there is an NVE where the blood is aspirated, and adodiathermy is used to cauterize the bleeder. We raise the IOP to 40 mm of Hg to see whether the raised IOP can stop the bleeding. We do base dissection to buy time for raised IOP to stop bleeding, but we fail to do so. So we switch on to fluid air exchange. After total fluid air exchange, we use fibrin glue, one drop each of two solution, which is put under air over the disc, and we see within 30 to 40 seconds it starts forming a reticulum which acts as a membrane to stop the oozer. We can see a definite membrane. If the membrane extends much beyond the disc, intraocular forceps can be used to gently grasp the edges of the membrane and to retract it over the disc. A After that, the residual fluid is removed and pan-retinal photocoagulation is started. We can see while the pan-retinal photocoagulation is going on, the disc oozing has already stopped. We do laser photocoagulation in all uncovered areas, followed by residual fluid removal and injection of silicon oil. So this is at the end of the surgery. On the third post op day, we can see partially absorbed membrane under oil, and on first week the membrane is totally absorbed. After 8 week of surgery, the BCVA is 20/80 and the VEP also show a very good response post-operatively. Thank you very much.